aspect no pag-aaral natin sa baptism. Number one, baptism is not a requirement to salvation. Only faith in Christ. Yun lang yung requirement sa atin para tayo maligtas. Number two, every believer in the Bible is baptized. So, meron tayong mga kaibigan, meron sa inyo dyan na probably you thought na hindi mo kailangan maging ma-baptize dahil in a way, Christian ka naman. And yet, when you look at the Bible, specifically when you go to the book of Acts, every believer in the book of Acts, immediately, as soon as they believe, were baptized. Every teaching in the epistles, those who believe were baptized. So, ibig sabihin na even though this is not a requirement to salvation, but automatically, if you are a Christian, if you are a believer, the Holy Spirit will work in your heart and you become obedient to the command of God. Anong command ng Panginoon? Sabi niya, you become a disciple and the first and foremost thing of a disciple is he is baptized in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. So yun yung klaro-klaro itinuturo. At ang sabi ko nga, this representation, the unity of the body of Jesus Christ. Itong baptism na to. In fact, when we look at one big example in Acts chapter 19, basahin natin as we close, begin. And it happened that while Apollos was at Corinth, Paul passed through the inland country and came to Ephesus. There he found some disciples, and he said to them, "Did you receive the Holy Spirit when you believed?" And they said, "No, we have not even heard that there is a Holy Spirit." And he said, "Into what then were you baptized?" They said, "Into John's baptism." And Paul said, "John baptized with the baptism of repentance, telling the people to believe in the one who was to come after him. That is Jesus." On hearing this, they were baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. And when Paul had laid his hands on them, the Holy Spirit came on them, and they began speaking in tongues and prophesying. So, pag nabasa mo yung Book of Acts, you will find na ang lahat ng mga believers is not satisfied just in believing Jesus. Because automatically, it is the call of the Lord Jesus Christ in Matthew 16 when he said that I will build my church. And building the church is based on the believers. And the church, the entry and the beginning of a church is through baptism. That's why we have the ordinance of baptism, which is very, very vital in the life of the church, especially of the church like Bangkok International Christian Fellowship. Shall we pray? Our Lord and gracious Father, we praise you and thank you for this time, Lord. We thank you, Lord, that you always give us the time to pray, to come together, to have communion, to enjoy fellowship. We pray, Lord, that for our brethren who might think that it is enough for them to believe, that they will be convicted by the Holy Spirit to see the necessity, the essential necessity of being baptized in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Oh, we pray, Lord, that this conviction will grow in their hearts, that they will desire to be baptized and to follow and to be obedient to your ordinance. For we pray all these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Okay, let's close our prayer meeting by singing our closing hymn, our closing song. And then may I request...